right, picking up on the themes from our last video, we have cleaned this bottom bracket out right here, and we have measured it, and we have determined that it is way too small. It will be, it's about 5/1000ths of an inch too small. All right, so this is like, that's like 0.1 millimeters, okay? That is so small, nothing will ever work in here. This bike will never be any good, believe it or not. So we have to fix it. Now this is an aluminum bike, so it's gonna be necessary to ream it. You're not gonna get this, you couldn't take off that much material with sandpaper or anything like that. It must be reamed precisely. This can also be done on carbon bikes, but there are some easier ways to do carbon bikes, and we can cover that in another video. But for aluminum, must be reamed. Now, we talked on the last episode that we can never assume that this hole is gonna be the right size, so we should measure it and know for ourselves. I bought this handy dandy little ream right here, if you wanna take a look down here. This is 40.98, okay? And it's 40.98, it says that on the package, right? Well, let's find out, all right? Because remember, we're not trusting anything here. So I'm gonna show you guys how to measure. Now, this is okay to use a vernier caliper for this. Now, what a lot of people try to do is they try to stick it like on here, on these like knife edges, and then they're kind of like rocking it back and forth and trying to find, you know, like a good place to stop. Now, I'm gonna show you guys the down and dirty easy way to measure a ream. And you do it like this. You let the tool do the work. You just hold these flat up against it, and you get on two of them. You see that right there? You get on two of them. And what you wanna do is you wanna hold this one, let go of the tool right here, and just roll it out. See that? See how that works? And you wanna go ahead and you wanna just roll it out. All right, so now you're seeing something here, okay, right there. You're seeing that this ream had some variability, let's say. It's basically 40.98. There's two tines on here that are 40.98. I've already measured it all out, but a lot of them are slightly under that. Whether that was intentional or not, who cares? The finish will be 40.98. Okay, now we feel secure that we can actually use this to create the proper hole diameter that anything that we put in there is going to be magnifique.